When I was a young man, I carried my pack, and I lived the free life of a rover. From the Murray's green basin to the dusty outback, I waltzed my Matilda all over. Then in 1915, my country said, son, it's time to stop rambling.
Every day for a year, from the 11th of November 2014 to the 10th of November 2015, the last face ceremony will draw special attention to particular soldiers whose lives and deaths can tell us something about the terrible conflict in which they were involved. Their stories are stories of mud and blood, of unspeakable suffering, and limitless human endurance. However, they are also stories of courage, devotion to duty, and comradeship. We remember them with gratitude, the sacrifice of these men, and the thousands of others that they represent. Tonight, we remember Lieutenant John Ainsley Pullen, who served with number 9 Squadron of the Royal Flying Corps and died on the 28th of November 1917 of severe wounds, age 21. John was the eldest of 3 brothers who came from Newcastle. He'd just completed his education at Rutherford College when the war broke out. He immediately volunteered and, after initial training, was sent to train as an officer. He was commissioned to the Durham Light Infantry.
as they carried us down the gangway. But nobody cheered, they just stood and stared.
So it's Saturday the 29th of November in 2014, and we've just had an amazing day with Remé driving us around the Western Front, the plague strand, and this is pretty much the place where Pop Brown was shot, or got actually shot, not, but he got hit by a bomb, and we talk in his diaries, he's talking about a place called the Red Lodge, which is over here. This is the Plague Strat Wood here. And then he was billeted in a convent, which is just down the back here. So it's a pretty amazing place, I guess, to think about being here 100 years ago. So we'll put a poppy in the ground for him to reflect upon. Reflect upon Pop. And I think the irony is that the name of his workshop he used to call the Red Shed, and he always painted it bright red. And I wonder whether or not that's something to do with the fields of Flanders. That's never dawned on me before, but you know, that could be the reason why it was his little... or the Red Lodge. It could be the Red Lodge as well, Remé. Yeah, or it could be the fields of Flanders. We never understood why Pop had his red shed, but it was always his workshop that was painted in red. So, maybe there's something to do. To you, Pop, I hope you have a beer up there somewhere.